Hey guys, welcome back to the This Is Soul Skate Shop YouTube channel. We're here in our store in Amsterdam at the wrist guard section because today I'm going to tell you all about those. Why would you wear wrist guards anyway? And why wouldn't you wear wrist guards? In this video, I'll explain everything there is to know about them. The short answer is that if you're really scared to skate and if it's your first time, then you better gear up. If you want to hear the complicated story, then continue watching the video. Some people wear wrist guards and some don't. Isn't it always better to protect yourself? In the Netherlands we have a saying and it goes something like this. Voorkomen is beter dan genezen. And it means to prevent something is better than to cure it. So how do we prevent falling on our hands? And we do this by falling on our knees. You might have seen this in our YouTube tutorial on how to fall, is that there's actually techniques that will teach you not to fall on your head and on your hands. So check out that video. I recommend it for all beginning skaters to learn how to fall. Because when you're falling on your knees, you're not falling on your hands. So the best way to prevent falling on your wrists is having good knee pads. So the reason why some skaters might not wear wrist guards is because they're really good at falling. Think about it. If you're already close to the ground, you can never really hurt your wrist anymore because you're super low. My favorite way to fall is called the mermaid technique. And it's a technique where you fall on your side and you sit pride straight up, just like a mermaid does. In this technique, your hand is actually bent 90 degrees like this because you're sitting like this. Most wrist guards prevent you from doing this position. So when I teach a group of children and they are wearing the wrist guards that will lock your wrist in like this, that group of children will continually during the lesson all fall out stretched on the ground like this because their wrist guard does not allow them to do a perfect mermaid technique. If I teach a group of children that does not wear wrist guards, then they do the perfect mermaid techniques and it's actually safer because then they're straight up, their head is not close to the ground, and also their body is more protected because you're just straight. It's a better position. This is one of the reasons why I myself also don't wear wrist guards, because I want to have the flex in my wrists. So if I would wear wrist guards, I would take one that's super flexy. There's different types of wrist guards and there's different types of flex within the wrist guard. And it's a really important aspect of the wrist guard. So for example, this Anui City Brace, there's steel in it and it's super stiff. So you cannot hardly bend it. And that also means that it protects your wrist really, really well. If you wear it, then it's really hard to flex. Then there's the Anui All-Round and the Anui Wrist Brace. They also have the wraparound kind of like shoelace that you can put around the wrist guards. And there's the normal wrist guards. The cheaper you go within at least the Anui line, the more flex it has. And then this one is comparable to any other like generic standard wrist guard. You can buy these separate, but these are also always the ones that come in a set. So if you buy a set of protection, there's always like a generic wrist guard included, just like this. If you don't like to have the stiffness at all, like me, then a really good option is also a glove like this, which does have some Kevlar protection, but it's just like super flexy. It limits the movement only a little bit, but the best thing that it does, it's like the Kevlar protects your skin. And you know when you fall and it's like super cold and you fall on the ground, you have this like weird feeling in your skin. It protects you from that, but maybe not so much for breaking your wrist. So if you're judging wrist guards, then an important thing is how flexy are they? Because it's such an important thing, we now actually include this on our website. There's an attribute and it's the flex of the wrist guard, so that if you shop online, you can always see how flexy this wrist guard is. The best way to judge the flex of the wrist guard is actually to come to our store here in Amsterdam. If you don't live in the Netherlands, maybe you can do like a fun weekend trip with your partner, just convince him or her like, hey, let's go to Amsterdam and see some of the beautiful buildings here. We're close to the Vondelpark, so you can skate around the Vondelpark, and there's cool skate parks here in the city to skate as well. And then to just like try all of these different types of wrist guards on in the store. This is by far the best way to judge the flex, but also the fit, because every hand is different. Some people have like long fingers like me, and some people have like short, thick fingers, and it's like every hand is different. And the way a wrist guard fits your hand is different for everybody. So maybe for me, this is the perfect wrist guard, but for somebody else, it just doesn't fit them at all. So with some wrist guards, if I do this, then it kind of like, how to explain this? Like there's a natural curve in the wrist guard like this. And with some of the wrist guards, for me, the curve is then like maybe in this spot or just like at that part. And there's no way to tell on a web shop really how the fit will be. So come to our store to try the flex, but also the personal fit of all the wrist guards. All right, the next part of judging the wrist guard is how grippy or slidey it is. So these are two kind of similar wrist guards if you judge them from this side. But if you flip it, whoop, it's totally different from this side. Because one is super grippy and it has like a more like a natural skin feeling to it. So if you wear it, you don't really notice it's that it's like super different from your normal grip in your hand. And then this one is a solid block of plastic and it's like super slidey. This one is made to slide. This one is used for downhill skating or like for people who go really fast and actually want to slide with their hands over the ground and do a special trick with that. Super cool to do that. This one is made for more like maybe aggressive skaters or skaters that are doing tricks where they want to be maneuverable and actually maybe grab some stuff while they're skating or while they're falling. And maybe like if you grind a rail, you want to jump off and grab the rail. And then you need that flex, but you also need the grip for that. So in general, the wrist guards that have the Kevlar or that have more like a grippy thing are more for grabbing stuff. And the wrist guards that have like a plastic thing here, like this, this is for falling and sliding. So people that are going like 20 or 30 kilometers an hour and they fall, it takes a while before they stand still. So you want to like glide with your hands over the ground. For speed skaters, I would recommend something with the plastic cap. When you go to a skate park and you see some good skaters, you might notice that some of these skaters only wear one. A while back, actually, I myself was injured because I fell on my hand too many times. Like after like 20 hits, my wrist was like, it was hurting a bit after the session. Like if I did this, it just kind of hurt. And then for like the next couple of weeks after that, when I went skating, I would wear a wrist guard to brace it. But I only had it on one hand. So if you ever see a skater and they only have one wrist guard, then now you know it's probably not because they forgot one. It's because they fell on their hand too many times and just want to protect it a little bit until it's healed again. All right, there's actually a new wrist guard on the market and it's called Flex Meter. And the Flex Meter wrist guard is kind of similar to like a standard version wrist guard like this, but it has built in flex so that if you fall, you can still do the 90 degrees angle with your hand to do the perfect mermaid falling technique on your side with this one. So there's an urban myth floating around within the inline skating culture. And that is, if you wear a wrist guard, that means that the wrist guard makes you break your wrist here instead of here. Have some of you heard this myth again? Because I've heard it like more than 100 times already. People keep on telling me this story. And I never actually seen somebody really break their wrist here because of the wrist guard. So let me know, please, in the comments, because I really want to find out if you have ever seen somebody break their wrist here because of the wrist guard. And I'm very curious if this is really an urban myth or if this actually happens. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and like this video. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.